It's a gorgeous summer day on the CP in Ottumwa, Iowa. We're standing at the Quincy Avenue crossing on the north end of the CP yard as southbound freight train 2270 approaches, crossing the Des Moines River Bridge in the distance. This is a second train being operated in addition to CP's usual 270 manifest, and we'll see it arrive in town later on. Thank you.
marker.
The train pulls into the yard and is tied down for a few hours, awaiting a new crew. 30 minutes later, we see another train at this spot, this time an empty coal train. This train is from the BNSF and has taken Powder River Basin coal from Wyoming up the CP to Muscatine Power and Water in Muscatine, Iowa. Now empty, the train is returned to Ottumwa, and after running the power around, we'll head back up the CP the other way and rejoin the BNSF at Lawler. Lawler is the junction on the CP where it meets BNSF's double track line, which runs through downtown Ottumwa. There is an interchange track here, allowing the BNSF coal trains to operate up the CP to Muscatine. The coal train we saw earlier now has its power switched, and we watch as it runs through the interchange track and back onto the BNSF main line to head west for more coal. We remain here at Lawler to catch some more trains that have just arrived. CP's northbound mixed freight 271 departs the yards to take its first cut of cars up to Rutledge Siding. With just two engines on the front, the train has to be split in two sections and doubled up the steep Rutledge Hill, a grade that begins shortly after this spot. 271 has to wait to put its cars in the siding at the top of Rutledge Hill because there's a southbound waiting for it there. Now, manifest train 270 takes its turn and drops down the hill towards the yard. Shortly before 7 o'clock, the train that opened today's action, 2270, finally gets a new crew at the Ottumwa Yards. We are ready to begin chase on the edge of town at 215th Avenue as the train starts its long journey south towards Kansas City. We say farewell to train 2270 as the sun sets in Mystic after a pretty busy day on the railroad.